Hey, what's up, guys? This is Nightwing2303 from KicksOnCourt.com. Today we have a quick look at the upcoming Nike KD6. This is the Seat Pleasant colorway. And again, it's not going to focus. Okay, there it goes. Sorry, I recorded this already and it wasn't working. These do fit small, so going up half a size is recommended. And I got a 9.5. They fit me perfectly. And with that being said, let's go ahead and get right into it. Alright guys, so here's just a quick look. Again, this is the Seat Pleasant colorway. This is their initial GR launch colorway. They already did their energy launch, which was the, I think it was like the DMVs or something. Like, I don't remember what they were. They were those weird ones with all the lines all over them. This is definitely not an appealing looking shoe, in my opinion, especially after getting them in person. This is probably the best looking colorway though. So I made a really nice Nike ID colorway, I will say that, but I'm not going to buy them or anything, so I just thought that they look nice on screen. As far as tech specs go, there is 4-foot Nike Zoom, and yes, it's the 10mm bag that is a long, skinny rectangle. It's not a full bag like what we've been used to, so this is just like the KD5, and same thing in the back, you have a Max Air unit in the back. This one feels a little bit better, though, than the previous version, and it's a little bit larger. Two things I noticed right when I pulled these out of the box. First thing is that they're extremely lightweight, so I was pretty surprised about that. And then the second thing is that when I put them on, the lockdown was incredible. This is a very, very low-cut shoe, and the lockdown looks like it's going to be lacking, especially since this is the last lace loop right here. This is the last eyelet. Usually you want something a little bit higher to kind of draw you into the back here. However, they designed this with that higher back and then the lower front. It really like kind of mimics your foot shape in general. So like your Achilles sits in here with your heel perfectly. And then this basically draws in the top of the ankle area, right where your foot will flex right around here. So I was very surprised at that. Again, they're really, really lightweight. Like, I was really surprised about that. I don't typically care about lightweightness and all that stuff, but this was one of those ones where I was like, oh, geez, these are pretty light. Move some of the paper. The fuse is, it's pretty pliable. However, there was a hot spot right where it starts to flex just because of these couple of overlay pieces you have that, I guess this is the lacing system or something, but you got that piece and you got the stitch on piece, and there's an additional tongue underneath. So it's just, it's a little bit thicker under there, so when it was flexing right here, I could feel it pushing into my foot. So maybe a double sock, I'm not quite sure yet. I'll figure that out later. And as far as how they feel pretty good actually. Again, really lightweight. The cushioning feels a little bit better than the KD5. And I'm sure with break in time, they will be just fine. Traction pattern looks a little bit worrisome, but feeling it, it feels pretty sticky. It's kind of weird. And then this is also really, really pliable. I don't know how well you can see it moving, but it moves pretty easily. I'm just worried about all these little weird point things where all the lines meet up. I just think that's kind of strange. But on a clean floor, it might work perfectly well. Dusty floors, I don't know. Outdoor courts also, like, it's pretty soft, so I probably would go with XDR, which would be Nike ID, or an Asia exclusive release version. Here is the inside, and it's an ortholite insole. Let's see if I can pull it out. So there it is right there. Helps with step and comfort. And yeah, these are kind of weird. They look funny on feet, and they look funny off feet too, so, I mean, you know, they look funny looking down. I haven't, like, checked them out in the mirror, like, wearing them, like, what they look like from the side and everything, but looking down on them, they look really strange just because of all the placement of everything. It just, I don't know how to explain it, it just looks weird. Yeah, let's see if I can get in there a little bit more. So there's this stuff. It's kind of strange. Yeah, everything's just real weird. If you've been following my site, you already have a lot of information on these already. I posted videos from Jacques Slade, who goes over why the tongue is like this. designer interviews with Leo Chang from Soul Collector and all that other kind of stuff. So if you haven't been watching or following my site, you might want to do that. I'm also post up detailed images of these guys. And I think that is pretty much it. So stay tuned for the performance review. And this guy here is number one priority, and the Soldier 7 is number two priority. But I'm going to try to be getting them done around the same time, hopefully. If everything pans out, I'm going to be playing on court a little bit longer than usual to try to get them done. And longer on court per night, I should say. And stay tuned for the APL review, too, because that is coming soon. That one's actually completed. I just got to finish recording and put it all together. So thank you guys for watching. Thanks for all your support. And until next time, guys, have a good one. Yeah. Stay down with my day one niggas and we in the club screaming no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no no new. DJ Khaled! Still here with my day one niggas, so you hear me say no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no no new. I still ride with my day one niggas, I don't really need no new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no no new. I stay down from day one, so I say fuck all y'all niggas except my niggas. Fuck all y'all niggas, except my niggas. One more time, fuck all y'all niggas, except my niggas. Fuck all y'all niggas. Stay down from day one.